I was asked to show how to create a leave tracker for employees' leave for the entire year. So this is how I start. The first of all is I have in column A, I go down a few rows and I start with your employees and leave enough space so you can write the employee names in here. And then in column B, I do sick, C, I do vacation, and D, I do blank. And then in the first cell next to the blank here is I put in January 1st, 2019, because we're doing it for this year. And then I drag these dates. And you keep dragging them till you reach the end of the year. So I'll just pause it for a second here. So I drag the dates till the end of the year, and so I get 1231 is column NE. So now what we're going to do is we're going to select all of these that we have highlighted, and then what we're going to do is we are going to change the formatting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and I'm going to select Format Cells. And from the box, I'm going to go custom. I'm going to select custom, and I'm going to select D to just show me the day of the week. And then I say OK. And so now I just have the day there. We need to select all of the columns from NE back to where we started. With all these columns selected, I'm going to right click and select a column width of 4. Three, and I say OK. Now all our columns are small, narrow there. I've right-clicked and inserted a new row above my dates here. And now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go use the weekday function. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select my FX key here, and I'm going to select weekday. And in that function, what I'm going to do is I am going to select the date below. And I'm going to say OK. Now, in the Microsoft world, Saturdays are 7 and Sundays are 1, so it's giving me the weekday. So I'm going to drag that down till the end of the dates. So with the weekdays calculated here, what we're going to do is we're going to select all the cells that were the days that they work on, and what we're going to do is we're going to gray out the Saturdays and the Sundays. So with all of these select now, we're going to go to the Home tab and we're going to go to Conditional Formatting. And we are going to select New Rule. And then we're going to select Use a Formula to determine which cells format. And then what we're going to do is we are going to select the days that we've the weekdays that we've calculated. So we're going to select from here. And then I'm going to put a full colon, and then I'm going to put NE is the last one that we had for the whole year. So I'm going to go NE. Now, we're going to take off the conditional formatting for the E. So we'll take the dollar sign off of the E. And we're going to take a dollar sign off of the N. So now what we're going to do is we're going to say if it equals equals 7, so that would be Saturday. And then we're going to set the format. And we are going to go to fill, and we're going to select gray here so that all the Saturdays will be grayed out. And we will do the same thing for all of the Sundays. Now, with all our weekends marked off, I normally just hide this row with the weekdays on it so that we don't need it anymore. So now what we do is we do, for the sick days, you're going to count if, and if S for sick, V for vacation, and B for bank. So what you're going to do is go equals count if. So we'll go to the function key and we'll go count if. And so then what we're going to do is we're going to select the range, and we're going to select from here, and then we put a full colon, and then we go NE4. And what we're doing is we're checking for the letter S. And then we're saying OK. And then we can drag that down. And we're doing exactly the same thing for V and B. And I will continue to do that for you. Now I've got the COUNTIFS done for the sick, the vacation, and the banked. And so just because we have so many things in here, what I would do normally is on like the first Monday of the second month is I would go in this cell above here. I would go equals, and I would select the cell that's above there or below there just so that we can get the month. Okay, and so now what we're going to do is we're going to right click and we're going to format. And instead of a custom day, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a custom month, MMM. And so it's going to give me the three letters of the name of the month. And so it says January there. And so then maybe you could make this larger so it's easier to see, and bold. And what you can do is that you can extend it into the next cell. Now, you could repeat that for every one of them. The other thing you would need to do is you would need to select the cell here, and you would go to the view command, and you would go to freeze panes, and you would go to freeze panes. And now you will be able to scroll all the way across. And once again, I would go equals this date, and press enter, and then you can format and select month, month, month. So that's how you create it. So now, for example, if I put in sick days here, they will be counted up. The sick days here, it doesn't matter when I'm putting them in, anywhere during the year. If I put in a bank day here, it will change the totals on the sheet. So that is how you create a yearly leave tracker for your employees. You can clean this up with lines and shadows, but that's the basic principle. Please subscribe.